I'm going to show you how to roll your own protection for your camera and your gear. Not only is it super inexpensive, it's readily available and it takes up almost no space. Hello, Ken Twinkley here with a photography tip. You know, I do a lot of outdoor photography, landscape and wildlife, and I love that. And many occasions we get into inclement weather, and actually that's some of the greatest times to be photographing, especially when you're right on the edge of rain and that. I do have actual fitted weather protection for some of my gear, some of my longer lenses and that, when we're designed to basically be out in the elements waiting for an animal or something like that. It can get a pretty good deal of water on it and it's not going to get the gear wet. But you know what? 9 times out of 10, I don't need that much protection, and it's relatively expensive. I have a really, really simple, cheap solution that you can pull out of your bag quickly and protect your gear. And it looks like this. I know this looks probably pretty odd to you. This is a homemade weather protection gear and accessories. Now, before we dismiss this, let me explain. Basically, what we're looking at are several rubber bands. Now, there's several rubber bands on here, basically because I'll know that there's rubber bands on this and I can come back to this little bag later, this little rolled up item, and I know I can grab a rubber band if I need it. And many times I've grabbed rubber bands because I've needed them. Now, what I've got in the roll, it's essentially a rolled up shopping bag. It's that simple, okay? All you gotta do is lay it out flat on a table, make it get the air out from the bottom up and fold it over from left to right and then roll it up really tight. And when you roll it up, again, put a rubber band on it, put 3 or 4 of them on there, and that way you've always got a rubber band available for you. Now, you will be shocked how many times you will use this for all sorts of purposes. Yes, I've used it to cover camera gear when there was rain. I've used it to cover my camera bag that was closed but was in weather, and I couldn't quite get it completely protected. I've used it for that. I've used it to put things in to keep them out of the sand when we're at the beach. I've also used it because we've been stuck at the beach with nothing other than my camera and my camera bag to collect seashells. And we collected driftwood when we're out in California as well. So there's all sorts of uses for this little rolled up protection that you can put inside your bag. The other great thing is you can put 5 or 6 of these in the bottom of your camera bag. They're not going to take up any space, and they're basically weightless. There's nothing there. So keep them in your bag, and you might be surprised how many uses you come up with these things that make them very helpful and very valuable in the long run. On my last trip up to Vermont, I bought some maple syrup, and I needed to put it in my checked bag, so I used several of these bags to wrap that bottle of Vermont syrup to keep it protected and to keep, if it leaked, keep it off my clothes and stuff. So, I mean, there's another use, but keeping that gear protected, of course, is number one. The rubber bands come into play. You could also put inside the bag, if you wanted to, you could put toothpicks, you could put a paper clip, you could put a Q-tip. If you needed a Q-tip that's clean and dry, you could leave that Q-tip in there and know that it's there and pull it out and use it to clean gear and do things of that nature. There's all sorts of options. It's really simple, doesn't cost anything, and it could save you if you needed. So try it out. Let me know if it works for you.